Veritasium recently made a video on QR codes and how they use the mathematics of error correcting codes so that they still work even if your phone doesn't take a perfect picture. But the Reed-Solomon codes in that video are a little bit tricky to understand at first. My philosophy when learning math is to start with the simplest interesting example. That's an example that's simple enough that you can fully understand it from start to finish, but is interesting enough that it gives you a sense of the math going on. For error correcting codes, this is my favorite example. It's called the Hamming 7-4 code, and it has this beautiful triangle of numbers arranged into three circles, and that's how it works. And you can understand it in 3D as a cube of numbers. In this video, I'm going to do a deep dive on my favorite error correcting code and show you how it works. Okay, so how does this code work? Let's pretend that Alice is sending a message to Bob, and Alice wants to send the message 1011. The problem that we're going to imagine that Alice and Bob have is that any of these four bits could be accidentally, by random chance, flipped in transit. So maybe Alice means to send 1011, but the message that arrives for Bob is 0011. That would be a disaster, the message would be completely ruined. So what we're going to do is come up with a way to figure out if there's a single error, if one of the bits gets flipped, how can we figure out which one was flipped and correct it? And to do that, we're going to take these four bits, 1011, and we're going to use them to calculate three error checking bits. So we're going to add on three more. They're going to go right here next to 1011, and they're going to let us find any errors in the original message. Let's see how this works. The first thing I'm going to do, so we can tell them apart, I'm going to color them in. So red, blue, yellow for the first three bits, and white for the fourth bit. Now I'm going to copy these bits into the circles that you saw before. So I'm going to draw three overlapping circles, kind of like a big Venn diagram, and I'm going to take these bits and I'm going to put them at the intersections between the circles. So the red bit is going to go right here between those two, blue over there, yellow down here, and white in the middle. By doing this, you'll notice that inside every circle, we have three bits with room for one more bit over here. Those are going to be the three error correcting bits. They're going to go in the part of the circle that has no overlap. And the one very important rule, in fact, the only rule for this code, is that the sum of the digits inside each circle must be even. That's the only rule. The sum of the digits in every circle must be even. So let's look at this top circle. We got 1 plus 1. It's already an even number. So what is the number that's going to go up there? Well, it's going to be 0. That would make the sum even. It would make the sum 2. All right, so 1 plus 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 2, which is even. What about down here in this circle? Well, here we got 1 plus 1 plus 1. That's an odd number. So to make it even, we're going to add a 1 over here. So you can kind of think of this 1, 1, 1 combines to give the error checking bit of 1 over here in this circle. And I've kind of color coded them so you can see where they come from, right? This orange error checking 1 came from the red, the white, and the yellow combined to give the orange 1 over here. What about that last circle over there? Well, there's two 1s. 1 plus 1 is 2 is already even. So you just need to put a 0 in that last circle. Okay, there we go. So now we have our three extra bits. 0 up there, 1 down here, and 0 over there. We're going to add these to the message and transmit them along with 1011. Okay, so Alice will send the message 1011010 to Bob. And when Bob receives the message, if one of these things is flipped by random chance or by noise in the message channel, Bob should be able to recover what the original message was. Let's pretend, for example, that the first bit, that red one over there, gets flipped. Okay, so it got flipped to a 0. So Alice meant to send 1011010, but Bob receives 0011010. So Bob has the wrong message. How is Bob going to figure it out? Well, Bob draws the same circles that Alice did to figure it out, and Bob looks at the circles and immediately notices the most important rule is violated. That rule that says the sum of every circle must be even is wrong in the top circle. Look, in the top circle, 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1 is an odd number. So Bob knows for sure somewhere in this circle there is a mistake. There's a mistake somewhere in here. Bob doesn't know which of these bits is wrong, but he knows for sure there's a mistake somewhere in that purple circle at the top. Similarly, if you look down here at the circle on the left over here, 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3 is an odd number. So again, there's a mistake. There's a mistake somewhere in this circle. And you can kind of think of this as the orange bit is sort of checking and figuring out that there is a mistake somewhere going on here. On the other hand, if you look at that last circle, there's no mistake over there. 1 plus 1 is 2, which is even. This obeys the rule that the sum of every circle must be even. So what does Bob see? Bob sees there's a mistake somewhere in the purple circle. There's a mistake somewhere in the orange circle. And there's no mistake over there on that circle on the right, because that one worked out. Which of these bits would explain these errors? Where could there be a mistake that would explain why there's a mistake somewhere in the purple, somewhere in the orange, and no mistakes in the green? The only place where there could be a one single bit flip that would fix it is that red bit over here. The one bit that would explain all the errors we're seeing is if this 0 is the one that was flipped. And indeed, that was the one that was flipped. So Bob knows, okay, let's flip it back. So Bob flips it back, and then he can fix in the original message, he can fix it back to a 1, and now he is able to read off the message that Alice meant to send. So he found the error and fixed it. And this whole scheme with the circles, it will find and correct any one single error. So if any of these bits are flipped, by looking at the intersection of these three circles, it's either in one circle or two circles or all three circles, that would be the middle bit, and Bob can find and correct the error. Okay, and I'll leave you with one thing that I teased in the introduction, which is that you can think of this message 10110 as coming from this triangle of numbers, which is written into three circles. But you can also think about it in 3D as numbers living inside a 2x2 cube. I'm not a very good 3D artist, so you see I've drawn all the ones as little cylinders and all the zeros are little spheres. But if you have this imagination that a one is a cylinder and that a zero is a sphere, it looks perfectly good to me. And you can see the picture is actually almost the same if you look at it from the right angle. You can see the one sort of in the middle, the red, blue, and yellow kind of on the corners, and then the purple, orange, and green at the intersections on those sides. And these three circles that you get, each circle has four numbers in it, and that is just like in the cube, each half of the cube has also four numbers. So there's 8 spots in a 2x2 cube, and if you cut it in half, you get 4 numbers. And there's 3 different axes you can cut it in half. Those are the 3 circles over here. So the cube and the 3 circles are actually representing the same thing. And the rule that the sum of the digits in every circle has to equal an even number is just saying that the sum of the digits in every hemisphere of this cube, a hemisphere being just cut it in half, must be an even number. Why is this important? Well, you can generalize from 3 dimensions, a cube, to a hypercube in 4 dimensions or 5 dimensions or any number of dimensions, and that will give you generalizations of this code to any number of bits. So you can send a message not just of length 4, but of any length that you want. And actually, 3blue1ren has a great series of videos on this that you should definitely check out if you want to see how it works for higher dimensions. You'll also notice that there is one bit missing. That's the bit that would serve like living outside the circles. You can add that back in to make the code Hamming 8-4 that has like a slightly better property. I'll leave that as an exercise.